Hello and welcome. Okay, today I want to show you a bit about inking with nib pens. Dip pens? You know, with the nib and the holder. It's not easy. Okay, I want to use three feathers in this one because I have them already lying on my desk, which is a G-pen. It's a Japanese one and it's quite easy to handle, I think. Good for beginners. This small feather here, I'm not sure how you call it in English, but in Germany we say a Russian feather. They are quite thin and this one's well, also quite soft. And this one, I don't know what it is and I couldn't put it in a proper pen holder. And it's, well, I would say it's in the middle range. I think I'm going to add a third one, which is hard. If I can find one. Wait a second. Here's a hard one. Also a Japanese feather, but I've already got it in its holder. So, let's see, I will take this out because I know it doesn't work good anymore, so I mostly use it for some effects. So we have these three. Soft, middle, hard. Nice. So let's start with the G-pen, the soft one. I've also doodled a bit up here, so let's see, G-pen. This isn't some special inking paper, this is just sketching paper. I will show you later. It's a bit rough on the surface and this, if you use too much ink and scratch over it, the surface will be destroyed and you will have some paper coming off. So it's not the best, but you don't need the best to ink. So there are different things you have to watch out for when you use a feather. I mean, in school you have those with the round nibs, if you have them in school. I don't know, I think in America you only have like those standard pens, the yellow ones, you know, the graphite pencils. Do you even use pens? I have the feeling you only use pencils in school. Whatever. In Germany we had fountain pens in school. We had to use them and yeah. So, and you were writing like this, scratching, and as you can see this is different. If you move it upwards and press too hard, it gets stuck in the paper and rips it. It destroys the paper. So you can move it upwards, but you cannot press hard on it while doing it, and I think that's one of the mistakes people often do. It's one of the mistakes I did at the beginning because I was using it like a pencil or a school fountain pen, and you can do that with those pens, but not with a drawing feather, which isn't round. It's it got a pointy tip and it's not good if you use it like this. Best way is to hold it like this and pull it down. Also, always go like this, you know, from here, pulling into this direction, quite straight. That's the best way. I mean, you can also make some effects by moving it sidewards, the lines will get thinner, but here's also the problem. If you have too much pressure, it's going to scratch the paper harder, like when you go down like this. It makes also scratching sounds, but you can feel it this way. It's harder to pull than this way. This is the easy way. So, and like I said before, there are different types of pens, nibs, pen nibs, and this one is a soft one, which means you can do this. You've got a bigger line variation, and it comes with practice. This feeling on how hard you have to press down to get this line weight. I tend to use sideward motions a lot to get thinner lines, but like I said, it's hard, or it can be hard at the beginning because of the pressure. So best is just put it down on the paper and don't press down. Try this a bit. Okay. Doodling and making lines and circle is a good thing to do at the beginning, and don't go over line too often, especially while it's still wet, or otherwise you can destroy the paper like up here. So, soft feathers are, well, the line weight might not be easy to control at the beginning, but you won't destroy your paper as easy with a soft feather than with a hard one. Soft nib. Sorry, I'm saying feather. I don't think that's the proper name in English, but whatever. Next one, this is a middle one. I don't have a proper pen holder. This was like the back of a stamp. It was this thick. But I wanted it since it's so thin and a bit harder, and I couldn't get a pen holder, a nib holder for this, a proper one. So, have no idea what name it has. It's even thinner. It's quite soft, but I don't know if you can hear it, but it scratches the paper a bit more because it's so fine. It's really thin compared to the cheap pen. Can you see it? I think so. Okay. So you're more likely to destroy the paper with this one than with the other one. I like the sketching paper. It lets me do a lot of stuff in here. The lines don't get as thick as with the cheap pen. Oh well, I have to press a lot harder to get thicker lines. I like this a lot for hatching. It's a really nice one. I don't think I've done a lot of dip pen drawings on this channel, but I really like to paint or draw with ink. Okay, now the hard one. It's a bit thicker at the end. I also couldn't get a proper pen holder for this one, which is why I've used some eraser in here. Kneadable eraser. doesn't has as much line variation as the others since it's so hard. So with hard ones it's easier to control the line weight since there isn't much variation. Now this one. Let's see. Okay. I think this is broken. Yes, it is. No ink flow. I have no idea why. Just won't come down, okay. Maybe it fell down or I had it in a pencil case and it got deformed. I think I can throw this away. Bye-bye. So, and as you can see, there are different sizes of feathers, which you need different pen holders for. I think the leader had a nice idea and did like these two circles in one holder. I don't like these holders, but it's a good idea. Now let's look at some special ones. There are these Proud ones. Nice for writing. Didn't fill up enough ink. Okay, I'm not good at writing, whatever. So, I don't use this one often, and I also got this. It has similar use. If I get it to use, to work. No, why are all my feathers broken? Ah, okay. I was just holding it upside down. Empty again. And I have this one. It's I think it was used by musicians, so they could just make all these lines with one stroke. Just the middle one doesn't work. I don't know why. I probably got one which is kind of broken. As you can see, it doesn't work. I thought it would be nice for some effects. Ah, okay, I got it to work. Have to hold it a bit more like this. Oh man. There are. I've got so much feathers I don't really use. Yeah, the last one is a bit thick and at both sides, but I mean it's okay if you just wanna draw your music points and stuff. I don't know how you call them. I think this one is wrong. I'm pretty sure it's wrong. Yeah, so that's okay. It's only for notes. Not every paper takes this. Another one would be broken by now. Okay. The ink is almost empty now. So let's see. Never forget to clean your nibs, because well, some inks might be waterproof and it's hard to get them off after they've dried. You can use rubbing alcohol and stuff like this, but it's way easier to clean them right after using them. This one isn't waterproof, by the way, but I prefer waterproof ink because I know you don't always use water on your ink drawings, but in summer you might get sweaty hands, and that also can destroy your drawings. Well, or some tea. I know it looks like coffee, but it's English tea with milk. I like that stuff. I think it's a Scottish blend. Ooh. Don't tell the Scottish people I've said that. I don't think they like the English people. That's at least what I've got from my little trip to Scotland. Oh, and glass feathers. No variation. This one glides quite softly over the paper. I'm sure there are others. You can use it like a school fountain pen. I like this one for writing or for masking fluid. Yes, I'm using this for masking fluid. It's easy to clean. Well, that's pretty much the reason why I use it. I have trouble with my brushes. So it's clean again, more or less. So I think that those were the basics of inking. Watch how you hold your feather. Look if it's soft, middle, or a hard one. They act different on the paper. Try out your paper before you do a proper painting on it, or drawing, or whatever, because it might get destroyed in the painting process. And that would be sad. I've destroyed some of my better drawings by using the wrong paper. But you usually make this mistake like one or two times and then learn out of it. I'm making much noise with my box full of feathers. I still have other ones, some are the same, like the cheap pen. It's a good one. I do recommend it, but if you cannot get one nearby, or you have to pay a lot for shipping and stuff, go to your next art store. They are just as good as the Japanese ones. And not all cheap pens are the same, there are also bad ones. It's just the form and the softness, which is pretty much the same. Also, there might be some wax on your newer nibs when you get them, so if they don't, if the ink doesn't flow properly, wash it off and hold it over a candle for a short amount of time to get the wax off, and then clean it again. Then that might help. And well, What else? Keep drawing. I was rambling a lot during this video. I hope this helped at least a bit. Those are pretty much the basics I can teach you about using dip pens. I should have looked up the name. Whatever, you know what I mean, those things and the ink and stuff. I don't know. If you wanna know anything else or want me to continue in any kind of way, you can write me, and don't forget to wait till your ink is dry, until you close your sketchbook, or I don't know, start coloring it, because it might end up smudging your paper. Maybe I'm going to tell you something about inks the next time. So, goodbye.